Hello children, this is in continuation to the previous video. This is the same chapter, the Narayanpur incident. I am on page number 16, paragraph 13. Is that all? Asked Manju in disappointment. Now Manju is quite sad and depressed seeing the procession because she was expecting something else, something big, something more funny, something that would be entertaining. But here she is disappointed seeing silent protest where college students had moved to the collector's gate and then moved back to the college. She says in disappointment, is that all? What else did you want? A dance? A drama? Babu asked scornfully. Now Babu is replying here to Manju and says to her, what else did you want? You wanted to see a drama here? Do you think it would should have been a dance? Right? So she's kind of being very sarcastic. But he understood her feeling and asked Mohan the same question when he returned home. Even he felt the same. Even Babu felt the same. So he had asked. Now he asked his elder brother Mohan the same question. Is that all? This is what you had called us for to see in the procession. Why did you go back so quietly? Were you scared of what the police would do? So Babu asked Mohan that why did you go all so peacefully and were you all scared of the police, that police would do some, you know, punishment, give you some punishment? Mohan seemed immensely pleased with himself. Scared? We had planned it this way. We knew they expected us to protest and be violent. Oh yes, they wanted us to do that so they could beat us up, haul us away to jail, but we are not prepared to go to jail. Now what is the answer Mohan gives? Mohan says he is very happy. He is immensely means greatly pleased with himself. He is very happy with himself. He says, scared? No, never. This was the way we had planned, that we will all go silently so that they have no chance to catch and put us in jail. So we behaved in a different manner. We knew they expected us to protest and be violent. They here is the police. We is the college students. They say that the police expected us to protest and be violent. Oh yes, they wanted us to do that so they could beat us up. And they wanted, if we would have done that, they would have beaten us up. They would put us into the jail, right? But we were not prepared to go to jail. We didn't want to go to jail. That was not the motive of the procession. So here we were quiet. We were peaceful. What was the point then? Babu asked. While Manju listened earnestly. Babu couldn't understand the explanation given by Mohan. So he says, what was the point then of, taking out a procession, going to the collector's office and moving back peacefully? What was the point of all this? It's like a declaration of war. This line is important. Please underline. He says it's like a declaration of war. Mohan tells to Babu that it's like a declaration of war. We told them. The college students told them. The police. Here it is the DSP. Now this is war. And for us, you are the enemy. This is war. This is the beginning of a war. And for us, you are the enemy. And what was the paper you gave that policeman? Babu is still inquisitive and curious. He says, there was a piece of paper that you gave to the policeman. What was it? So Mohan replies, he says that was a notice we served on the collector as a representative of His Majesty's government, asking them to quit India or face the consequences. Now what was there in that paper? It was a notice, a written notice that these students, as representatives of the Indian people, gave to the collector, because collector is a representative of His Majesty's government, the British Crown, right? He is working for the British official. So he is a representative of the British Army. And what we had written them, we had pleaded them, we had requested them to quit India, to leave India. And if they don't do that, then they will have to face the consequences. Consequences here means the results. Whatever favorable, unfavorable results that will be, they will have to face it. right? Para 20. Suman and another boy turned up after they had finished their dinner that night. Now, after the dinner was over, Suman came with another boy. The boy staggered in with a large newspaper covered parcel in his hands. Staggered is walked as if he might fall because of the heavy object he was carrying. So both of them, they were holding a parcel, and the boy was finding it difficult to walk with a large newspaper covered parcel in his hand. "Here, let me help you," said Mohan. "My room, okay, Amma." Now there's something they are carrying, and Mohan comes and says, "Here, let me help you," to Suman and to another boy. He says, "Let me help you carry this parcel." And then he asks Amma, right? "My room, okay. Shall we keep the parcel in my room, Amma?" "No, I think the puja room is better. A light there will look more normal." So the reply from Amma comes that, "No, don't keep it in your room. Keep it in the puja room." Why? Because a light there will look more normal. There is light in the puja room always. So when the light will be on, it will be very normal and nobody would be suspicious of what the parcel carried. "Right as usual, Amma, the puja room then." So this the thing comes that, you know, Amma is the eldest. So Amma says the puja room, and he says, "Yes, as usual, Amma is always right. So let's keep the parcel in the puja room." The boy went away after a whispered conversation with Suman. The other boy who was with Suman, he now leaves and he whispers something into Suman's ear. Then Suman, Amma and Mohan went into the small puja room. Three of them, right? See, Suman, Amma and Mohan, they go to the puja room. Babu and Manju stared curiously over their shoulders at the mysterious parcel, which turned out to be a cyclostyling machine. Now these two siblings, Babu and Manju, they are staring and they are full of curiosity, wanting to find out what is there in the mysterious parcel, which ultimately was the cyclostyling machine, right? Now what is a cyclostyling machine? A cyclostyling machine used in the past to make many copies of a letter or a document quickly. It's a copy, it's a copier, it's a photocopier or a photostat machine. In the olden days, it was called a cyclostyling machine. So here it is used probably to make copies of patriotic speeches in that point in time, because the people were still struggling for independence from the British rule. "Babu," said Mohan, as they settled down to work, "sit out in the front room and keep a watch." Now what does Mohan tell Babu? Mohan says to Babu, after the settling of this machine is done, "You sit in the front room and keep a watch. Keep seeing. If there is anything suspicious, tell us. Give us a warning if anyone seems to be coming to our house. Manju, go to bed." Or else, he went on noticing her crestfallen face, "You sit here in the hall and pass on Babu's warning to us." Now Manju is also asked to go to bed. And because she gives a crestfallen face. Now crestfallen face is a disappointed or a sad face. Why? Because she was not given any tasks. So now Mohan gives her a task that you sit in the hall and pass on any information that Babu gives to us. So it's like Babu is sitting outside, then Manju, and Babu will send information to Manju and Manju will pass it on to the family members. Amma, Suman and Mohan got to work at once. Got to work at once, that means they are now opening the parcel. Manju peered at them from the hall. In a little while, she began to feel drowsy and had to struggle not to doze off. Now, drowsy means she is about to sleep. She is feeling sleepy. And she had to struggle not to doze off. Doze off means going into deep sleep. So she is struggling not to sleep. Why? Because she has to give information that Babu will give to her. Okay, paragraph 27. Babu sat outside, alert and attentive. He felt a thickening in his throat. Underline thickening in his throat. He felt suddenly emotional and excited. It was beginning. and at last he was doing something. So he is excited because he has got a responsibility. He has got a task and he wants to be sincere in performing his task that Mohan had given him. Suddenly he tensed. Something is there that tenses him. And what is there? A man riding a bike stopped right outside their gate. Yes, he was getting off. He was opening their gate. Babu flung himself inside. Manju turned a startled face to him. Startled means shocked, surprised. Right? So what happens? There is a man who is on a bike. He stops there. He is getting off, opening the gate. Babu flung himself inside. Flung is immediately. He goes inside to convey the information to Manju, and Manju is shocked to see this reaction coming from Babu. Someone's coming in. Now he's giving information to the three of them in the puja room and Manju that somebody is coming in. There was silence. From inside the puja room, three faces looked at him. Three faces, we know three faces, Suman, Mohan and Amma looked at him. Then Amma got up and came out, followed by Mohan. Amma came out first, then Mohan came. Suman stayed inside the puja room and Mohan closed the door of the puja room. Manju, to bed. Babu, you too. Now this is Mohan instructing Manju and Babu to go to bed. Both of them should go to bed and sleep. There was a knock on the door. Babu rushed to his room, unrolled his bedroll and threw himself on it. Unroll means he opened up the bedroll and he threw himself on it wanting to sleep. Who's there? Amma called. Mohan, go and see who it is. Now somebody is knocking at the door. So Amma calls out, says, who's there? And then she tells Mohan, go and see who it is. Manju, who had got into her bed too, noticed that though Amma's voice was steady, her hands trembled. Now Manju is also gone to bed, but from there she notices that Amma's voice was stern, strong, but her hands were shaking or trembling. Now this is because of nervousness. Also this can be because of age. So trembled, you can write shook. Trembled, shook. Now Mohan came in saying, Amma, it's Patil, the sub-inspector. So who was outside? Outside there is a sub-inspector whose name is Patil. I haven't come to trouble you, a strange voice said. Now this man enters inside and tells both of them that I have not come to trouble you. Your husband was my friend in school. I'm a friend. So your husband is Amma's husband. Amma's husband and Patil, they both were friends in school, and he says, I am a friend. I am a well-wisher. Amma got up quickly and went out. Manju waited a moment and followed her. So Amma quickly gets up and she moves out, and Manju is also following Amma. There was Babu coming out of his room, making a show of having woken up out of deep sleep. Now they're doing drama here. So Babu pretends as though he has got up from a deep sleep, and he is making a show of having woken out of a deep sleep. The man was saying to Amma, yes, we were in school together. The man is Sub-Inspector Patil talking to Amma, saying that yes, we were in school together. That means Mohan's father and Patil. Oh, he was. And then he was about to say something, and then it is incomplete sentence. It's quotation mark close. Please, Patil Sahib, said Amma rather impatiently. Tell me why you are here. Now, Amma is getting impatient, restless. She wants to know why he is here. It's like this. There's going to be a search of your house. So he gives information to the family members, to Amma, that I am here. It's like this. Why I am here is that it's going to be a search of your house. When? She asks when? Most probably tonight, same night. I heard the sahibs talking. Now sahibs here means the British officials, the police officers, the sahibs, they are called the sahibs, they were speaking of a cyclostyling machine. Now they know about the cyclostyling machine. It seems you people are making copies of Mahatma's speech. They say you have people hiding here as well. So they have the information that you have a cyclostyling machine at home. You are using it for copying Mahatma Gandhi's speeches and spreading patriotism. They also say that you have people hiding here as well. Ha! Mohan scoffed. Scoffed is laughed at someone or said something in which you show that a person that you have no respect for them. So it's kind of a ridicule. As though it's a lie. But you have the cyclostyling machine. Sub-Inspector Patil continues. Right? He says, you have the cyclostyling machine. No, said Mohan angrily. So Mohan completely denies and says, no. You're wasting your time spying on us. Spying is secretively gathering information. Spying is secretively getting information, right? Next page, page number 18. Tell me, the man ignored Mohan and spoke to Amma. So man, Sub-Inspector Patil now doesn't listen to Mohan because he has denied and he goes on to speaking to Amma. Yes, Amma replied simply, and Mohan made an angry hissing sound. So Amma is confessing here. She says, yes, we do have the cyclostyling machine. Mohan is getting angry. He's making angry hissing sound, telling Amma, why are you telling this to Sub-Inspector Patil? Where is it? Sub-Inspector Patil says, where is it? Amma says, inside. Give it to me. I'll get it out of the way. So says, give it to me, I will get it out of the way. I will get it out of the way means I'll take the cyclostyling machine away from here. Mohan burst out again. Amma, what are you doing? How can you trust a policeman? So Mohan is still persisting that, Amma, what are you doing? Why are you trusting this policeman whom we don't know at all? The man touched Mohan on the shoulder. Sub-Inspector Patil touches Mohan on the shoulder. Mohan, you are still very young. I am a policeman. Yes, but your father was and still is my friend. So he believes in true friendship. He says, I am a policeman. Yes, I am serving the police. Yes, but I am still a friend to your father and I was a friend to your father in school. And this is my country as much as it is yours. Now give it to me quickly. Now this shows that this man is very patriotic. He has the same patriotic feeling. He says, give it to me, the cyclostyling machine. Please pass it on to me. Now he says, now give it to me quickly. Sub-Inspector Patil wants the cyclostyling machine quickly. Amma opened the door of the puja room and said, Suman. Now Suman, you remember, is still inside the puja room. Suman emerged looking anxiously at them. Amma smiled at her and said, Sir, Suman. Amma is smiling at Suman. Suman is a girl. And said, you have to get away. Take away all the material. Mohan, will you? She says to Suman, you have to get away. Please leave now. Take away all the material. Mohan, will you? She's giving some responsibility, some task to Mohan, but it is incomplete. Maybe help. They need help. So Mohan ducked into the puja room and lugged the machine out and gave it to Patil. So Mohan goes quietly into the puja room and lugged is moving with difficulty because it's big cyclostyling machine. It's big in size and he brings it out of the puja room and gives it to Patil. Do you have a largish bag? The man asked. Largish? A big size. Largish means big. Big size bag to keep the machine inside the bag. Manju, Amma began, but Babu had already got it. So Amma was about to tell Manju to bring a big sized bag, but Babu already got it, right? So Babu is very receptive. And then they were gone. Who were gone? Patil, Mohan and Suman. Three of them take the cyclostyling machine with Sub-Inspector Patil, Mohan and Suman. The house seemed unbelievably quiet after the earlier activity. And now there was pin drop silence inside the house. "Let's go to bed," Amma suggested. Now Amma tells who's left, Babu and Manju, to go to bed. Mohan came back shortly. "Suman?" Manju asked him anxiously. "She's all right." Now Mohan comes back shortly. He comes immediately. "What about Suman?" Manju asked Mohan, "Where is Suman?" So he says, "She's all right." "Go to bed, Manju," Amma said. So Amma wants Manju now to sleep. Bed, with the police about to come, because you remember there's going to be a search of the house now. The real police is going to come. So he says, "Bed, with the police about to come." It was impossible to go to bed and sleep. But nevertheless, she did drop off and came out of her sleep to hear a loud knock at the door. It was repeated. The same things happening again. "Who is it?" Amma called. Again the same things happening. First time it was Sub-Inspector Patil. When he knocked, Amma said, "Who is it?" Again, it is the somebody is at the door, and she says, "Who is it?" "Open the door," a strange voice ordered. Again, there is a stranger outside and they say, "Open the door." "Mohan, see who it is," said Amma. Again, previous event we remember, Amma tells Mohan to see who it is. Again, the second time, Amma again tells Mohan to see who it is outside. It was like going through something all over again. This line is important, please underline. It was like going through something all over again. This means same events were happening second time exactly in the same manner. So same, it was like going through something all over again. It was like a rewind. It was like a replay. But this time they knew for sure that it wasn't a friend standing outside. No need for Mohan to announce, "Amma, it's the police." But this time the only difference from the previous events and in this event was that it was now the real police standing outside. So they knew it already. They were already warned by Sub-Inspector Patil. Therefore, Mohan need not announce to the family members that, "Amma, it is the police," because they already know that it is the real police. So that finishes off your chapter. It's an extract from the Narayanpur incident by Shashi Desh Pandey. Extract means a piece, not piece. Write the spelling P-I-E-C-E. You can also write E-X-C-E-R-P-T, excerpt, right? Thank you so much. We'll see you for the next video and the next chapter very soon.